Hi, I'm Barbie Geckern.
And I'm Erin Barter.
We're from EduTERC, and our team is researching how game-based learning could transform education.
Together, Barb and I are going to give you an overview of our DRK-12 grant and how we're studying learning and teaching computational thinking with the game Zoombinis. Working with Ryan Baker and his team at UPenn, we're building educational data mining detectors of implicit learning in Zoombinis gameplay, learning that we can see through moves players make in the game, but that they can't yet express verbally or on a test.
The data logs that are generated naturally through gameplay allow us to watch how students are learning computational thinking implicitly. And that's really cool, but you might be thinking, so what if a student is a great Zoombinis player? What does that mean about their skills outside of the game?
Exactly. Game-based learning alone isn't enough. Implicit knowledge built through gameplay needs to be connected to classroom learning, and that's where the teacher comes in. We've developed a bunch of what we call bridge activities to help teachers make those connections. Here's what it looks like with Zoombinis. Teachers can use video clips with game examples to guide class discussion about computational thinking, have kids physically reenact Zoombinis puzzles, or play board games like Mastermind. We also provide visual materials that teachers can hang on the wall in their classrooms to reinforce key concepts and vocabulary, graphical organizers like data tables, and activities that use the programming language Scratch to make stronger links to coding. And we tie all of these activities to standards from Common Core and NGSS.
We're currently working with 40 third through eighth grade teachers as they use Zoombinis, bridge gameplay, and log about their experiences. But enough about us. Let's hear from the teachers.
A lot of the abstract thinking skills and logical thinking skills that go along with the computer science, so the problem decomposition and all of those strategies that they're using has helped them with their coding as well.
We're combining Zoombinis and Scratch so students can understand the sequence and the process of how to make a Zoombinis and how to put those pieces together in order to kind of emulate gameplay that they've played before.
One of our students, JB, I'll call him, refuses to write in math class. He doesn't have this skill and really reluctant. However, in Zoombinis, he became our class leader, even though other areas in class he has not been as successful. But with Zoombinis, he was absolutely a star.
By combining something kids love, playing games, with the power of educational data mining, we're able to offer teachers a fun and effective way to support a diverse range of learners.
Zoombinis has the potential to tap into the computational thinker in all of us.